Christ, through the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, now and forevermore. We are back to continue the discussion which centers at the consequences of Christmas. We've talked and the Father had used the things that have been said hereunto to set up a foundation, to create a foundation, to indicate that indeed Christmas is not to his glory, it's not to the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ, it is to the glory of the Son God that is being worshipped all over the world. Son God, the Son. That is why today is called Sunday. 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 Sun, S-U-N, Sun, Day. Constantine, like I said earlier, was manipulated to pretentiously adopt Christianity and made it the Roman religion. In which case, all those churches established by Peter, Paul, and all of them that were preaching then in Rome, all those souls they won, all those souls that they contributed in walking in the light of God, rather became eventually things of Satan by virtue of Constantine's manipulation in partnership with principalities of darkness who rule the world using emperors and kings of the world. The God that is being worshipped in this world is a feminine God. It is a woman and the left hand of God. Of course, spirit of darkness. Having carved out earth for herself, she had from time immemorial control activities of the earth and be in charge of, she has been in charge of the inspiration behind all the empires and emperors that has prevailed hitherto. Is a feminine God, and in the principle of God, the position of woman represent materialism. God uses the spirit of a woman to dispense blessings upon every family. That is why I admonish people who desire to marry to pray, seek the face of the Holy Spirit so that he will reveal your own wife, the one he has appointed and anointed for you purposely. Otherwise, everybody stands, if you have to choose for yourself, you stand 99% the chance of being given a wife by kingdom of darkness. And when that happens, that begins to manifest a whole lot of crises. Your spiritual life will be battered and disorganized because you have a wrong woman around you. It is the spirit of a woman, a virtuous woman, that God uses to channel blessing to every home. So that having been the authority of woman as appointed by God, now the world resorted to worshipping a feminine God, which is Isis, as I mentioned earlier on. Isis, their first land of manifest, was in Egypt, and Isis, being the head, the woman, that is why in the pagan world, like I said earlier on, in the pagan world, women have upper hands. So, because the God that the world worship is a feminine one, a feminine God, and taking advantage of the fact that she happened to be in custody of God's resources, she splashes the entire earth, especially those who give her ritual, who donate blood to her annually, and she makes them prosper with the instrumentality of her darkness energy. And on Christmas Day, that is a day the sun, the energy sun, like I said earlier on, I have said it repeatedly, is a deity, it's a planet, and there is a deity that governs it. That deity is Mother Earth. There is a quantum of energy inside the sun. There is a quantum of energy inside the sun. That energy becomes that geometry of O. And that is the energy she radiates onto the world and uses it to manipulate the earth. And having chosen a lot of people who are from her generation, who are her offspring, and made them to always realize that her, each time they come into this world, is not one generation thing. The moment they make covenant with her or any of her segments, because she has other gods within her sovereignty, she has other gods. So if you make covenant with any of her god, of course by extension it is her you have made covenant with, in which case she influences every religion, every organization, every nation, especially all those nations that had thrived through the principles of paganism. Paganism started from Egypt, just like in the case of God, where he revamps and reunites laws and covenants every 2,000 years. That also is applicable in the kingdom of darkness, in the satanic kingdom, which is the world of pagan. In Egypt, the rain had made Egypt the cradle of civilization. Egypt became a melting point of every occurrences, every activities of the world, especially when it has to do with acquisition of power, energy. Egypt became the center point, which was what informed Alexandra of Macedonia, the Macedonian king who reigned as a Greek emperor and also lived in Egypt. Why he lived in Egypt is the same thing we are saying. Egypt, it has to be in proximity with that center of power. In fact, I earlier made mention of the alien forces who fell onto the ground and evolved all these metals, precious metals. Egyptians who hobnobbed with them, those aliens, were taught on scientific subjects. They were groomed for invention. Those aliens taught the ancient Egyptians and the early men of those days how to manufacture weaponry, how to make war, how to do this, how to do that. All of this is that is congesting the earth now, and the source of men lusting after. Those things are inventions of those aliens. And that is why, as you can see, in Sahara Desert, is deposited a heap of sand. Sahara Desert, in other words, is made of sand. The entire stretch stretching up to mountainous region of Babylon, all that area are desert. God didn't create any desert. There was no desert in the history of creation. What happened was that the planetary, it was a war, you know, a galactic war between forces, which, you know, took place. And as like I said earlier on, the scientists call it the Great Bang, the Big Bang of the universe. So, planetary, you know, the things in other planets, planetary elements from other planets were deposited on the Earth, including the heap of sand. Under that heap of sand were the Egyptians excavated, the Egyptians, those who are into Egyptology, Egyptians and astrologers, you know, excavated and discovered those artifacts, discovered, what do you call it, tablets with all the inscription and hieroglyphic inscriptions of Egyptian mythology. Eventually, it was analyzed by the Egyptian priest, and eventually they did now understand that those are the formula by which you can accomplish whatever thing you are desirous of. That was why Alexandra built the first university. The first university that was ever built was built in Egypt, in a place called Alexandra, because he named, having conquered Egypt, he named that place after himself. And he built the first university there, where they learned mysticism, metaphysics, astrology. Almighty God are expanding. That was the veil over the earth is where they preserved that manuscript. Give your children to read, and the entirety of the inhabitants of the earth, armies of heaven, those who are wired to long after powers and energy, of course, migrated to Egypt to learn mysticism in that university Alexandra built. And the subject of learning there is those things they found from alien forces. When the Babylonians got Egypt, got to Egypt, they got some of those manuscripts from temples and sanctuaries. You know, then Egypt were scattered with all sorts of temples. They got the little they could get, and that was what they used in ruling the world. You know why? Because Mother Earth had relocated from Egypt and has manifested in Babylon. And like I said earlier on, in Babylon, they assumed a new name. Isis, the mother, who is the head of the Umphum of Trinity, became Semiramis in their new manifestation in the, Babylon. Tammuz was the son of the Umphum of Trinity, just like Christ is the Son of God. Tammuz plays that role by way of counterfeit. Then Nimrod, as the Father God, the role the Holy Father, the Universal Father plays, is now counterfeited for Nimrod to occupy it. That is really having counterfeited all of those and manifested naturally here on Earth. That energy radiated, and of course, with it, they built sophisticated empire, I mean Babylon. This, like I say, these empires are made of different metals. Like we said yesterday, Egypt was made of gold. Babylon was made of gold. middle pitcher was made of silver. Greek was made of bronze. Of course, the almighty Roman Empire was made of iron. And that is why, because iron has the capacity to shatter other metals, that is why when Rome emerged, Rome crushed all other empires that hitherto prevailed, including Egypt. Let me tell you what the Romans did in Egypt. When, in the days of Queen Cleopatra and Mark Antony ruling in Rome, Rome went to war in Egypt. When they overpowered the Egyptian army, they moved straight to the library of Alexandria. They carted away all those mystical books that enabled the world build astonishing technologies now. All of them were embedded and enshrined in that book. There are many names they call it the Egyptian Book of the Dead, in the Book of Necromancery. There are many, many names they call it, but it is just the book that has the content of how to carry out scientific invention. And it was in those days spirituality were counterfeited and presented as science. Spirituality was counterfeited and presented to man as science, because those gods teaching mankind these things does not want those who are not initiated to understand what is going on in their world. It's only when you are an initiate that you are made to know, and you are assigned a deity that will be a teacher and guiding you towards works of darkness. That is why it is endless. The moment you start, don't even start. If you start, it is endless. So, the Romans invaded Egypt, carted away those manuscripts, hid it, now played pranks with the world, went and brought all other documents that relates to taxes and census and other irrelevant documents. They brought it to the public glare and set it ablaze. In other words, making the world to think that thing everybody travel from different walks of life to go learn has been destroyed, has been removed from where the library of Isaiah and Alexandra, and thereby carted those other useful ones, the ones they consider useful, the one that made them come to Egypt, carted them back to Rome. When the 10 barbarian tribes that the entire Roman Empire is consist of, because Roman Empire is consist of 10 different barbarian tribes, they are the new Europe we are seeing now, but in those days they were 10 different barbarian tribes. Let me mention their name. Alamanni is the Germans. The Burgundians are the Swedes. The Sorcerers are Britain. The French are the France today. The Lombards are the Italians. The Astragos, the Heruli, the Vandals, those ones were extinct, like I said earlier on, they were extinct by Pope Justin under the mandate, under the instruction, the executive fiat of the Pope, because then the Catholic Church therefore has fully infiltrated the Church of Rome, which was the first church, and is now sitting on the throne and administering the affairs of man, because as at then the entirety of the world collapsed into Roman Church, and then they call themselves Holy Roman Empire under the supremacy, authority, and ecclesiastic rulership of the Pope. Military rulership, political rulership, Pope assumed absolute power. And as such, used that position to victimize those who ordinarily, all of those who did not, who were not adherents to their new doctrines and dogma. Because when the pagans, like I said earlier on, invaded the church pretentiously because Emperor Constantine had adopted Christianity then to be the official religion of Rome, everybody became a Christian. And not that they became a Christian sincerely. They went with their ritualism and all the dogmas of Satan that is known for. You see, if you go to Roman Catholic Church, you see that thing that look like a song. Even the thing they give that thing, the Holy Communion, they raise like this. It is the symbol of song. They are symbolizing their God. So that is how the kingdom of darkness manipulated and got their God, the sun God, infiltrate the temple of God and sat on the throne of the Roman Church for 1,260 years.